reason why Missy B is on is because Missy and I have been analyzing different narcissists that we find on the internet. And this new guy cropped up for me anyway recently when Aaron Imholte of Steel Toe came out and announced. And this is something that we don't see very often, so this is fun. He came out and announced that he's not a narcissist. He went and saw a professional and they said, nope, you're good. And only a week had passed since he declared he was a narcissist. So they were able to diagnose him and give him a clean bill of mental health in just 6 days.
Great. Case closed.
Case closed. Very impressive. That's what I thought too. I'm like, oh, he's not a narcissist. Okay, let's move on. Let's look at someone else. But then I thought, wait a second. Could he be lying? Is he maybe a liar? So I thought I'd have Missy B look into this. And also, I'll tease this before we end this segment. Nick Rekieta finally dropped a live stream reacting to Aaron and everything that he's done. And I have Aaron reacting to that. So we'll be watching that in just a little bit. Thanks to TV's Will Heron for clipping that for us.
Coming up.
Yes. But Missy B, where are we going to start here?
So, you know, I'm not... I looked into Aaron, and I don't really know much about him. Mm-hmm. So I did have to do some diving, but I wanted to, in short, I do have to agree with his psychologist, whoever you saw, that he is not necessarily textbook narcissist. However, okay. Let's also look into the situation that he's in. And I want to kind of keep our scope within his divorce.
You know what?
And we also have to apply the substance abuse that is being played with him. This is true, because when there is a substance abuse, you do exhibit certain behaviors that maybe you wouldn't normally.
He did try cocaine 3, maybe 4 times. That's true. Over 6 months.
And these are things that he could be lying about, but deceit doesn't necessarily justify narcissism.
Sure.
So these are big things. So I wanted to go down the big 9 that we had gone through with John, who got a roaring 110%.
John aces every quiz. He's amazing. Always
he is
hundreds.
Really good. You know, I mean, that Menza, he... So, all right, let's go down these big 9 narcissistic characteristics. And these are the big 9 that psychologists use. Okay. This is from a textbook.
You don't have to be all 9, but if you're more than 6.
There is a threshold for 7.
Yeah.
6, 7.
Yeah.
But then you have, there is a differential. Differential means other kind of personality disorders, substance abuse. And these are things that kind of pull you away from a hard-hitting narcissist. So what we have here, let's start with 1. Grandiose sense of self-importance. I have the word possibly. Now, I have it because he does exhibit a hot-headed ego. And yes. I think that makes sense. He's a guy who has his own show. He just has that kind of type A personality in that way.
Well, Missy, I have my own show too, but I've never said that when it comes to broadcasting, it's Anthony Cumia, Bubba the Love Sponge, and me. Aaron, on the other hand, has said that. So that's insane.
Okay.
So I'd give him a check mark on this one.
When you have hypocrisy doesn't necessarily justify narcissism either.
Correct.
In all these things, there are some scenarios, but there are a couple things here that I just, you know, it wasn't hard hitting for me personally. I was like, sure. Does he have this? Sure. But is he that? It doesn't hit me that way. But we can get to the whole, you know, how is he handling this divorce? Is it the best way that we could agree on? Maybe not. But
it's
again,
definitely not. That's not up for debate. But all right,
right. I'm not here to pile on shit. So now 2, right? Preoccupied with fantasies of ultimate, unlimited success, power, brilliance, beauty, or ideal love. I put no. I don't see that whatsoever. Do you have an example where you think that that fits?
I don't know specifically. I do know that he's already involved with another girl and he's been bragging about that. And I don't know if this has anything to do with narcissism.
No, that's not narcissism. I would
probably
say that's
not.
Just somebody who is going through a very traumatizing, tough situation
actually,
and how
second.
They choose to handle it.
Let's think about this, because Aaron himself said he was a narcissist for putting his wife on the show. So he needed to show everyone the eye candy.
Maybe
that
he doesn't even
that
know
that
what the fucking narcissist is.
Well, no, I know. That's true. But you know what I mean, though? Like, the fact that he married a younger hot chick, and he's like, well, you got to sit next to me so everyone can see that I married a hot chick.
Okay. All day for 4 hours a day.
Oh, yes. Right. Yeah.
Trophy wife mounted.
So, anyway, all right. We'll put a maybe on that.
No. I'm just being the devil's advocate.
Of course. He's already involving his new broad with the show just by mentioning her.
Of course.
So, yeah,
here
we go.
Sounds really messy. Sounds really messy. So, that. All right. Number three. Believe they are superior, special, or unique, and expect others to recognize them as such.
Okay.
I have no, but... You know, like I said, it is sticky in this muddy with this divorce thing that he has exhibited and put us out there. But there are, sounds like, a lot of details that haven't been disclosed, which was kind of, you know, we'll see with your clip, Carl. Yeah.
Just about anyone who does their own show, and he's a radio guy and he was the morning guy on a radio show, I think you could put a yes check mark next to anyone like that. You got to remember, Missy. You're dating Anthony Cumia. We live in a world of hanging out with podcasters and other people. Most people in this world do not want to put themselves on the internet for everyone to see and talk about how great they are. Aaron does.
Yeah. I mean, most people in radio really have egos. Every single one of them I've met. Even in the when they're on shitty, terrible stations. Yeah,
they think that
like
them talking is endlessly entertaining for everyone else.
Yeah. And those are personality-like disorders, right?
Sure.
Those can qualify under...
That dude in town who does that home repair clinic, the guy walks around like he's fucking Fonzie.
He pays for his time on the radio and still thinks that he's got a big radio show.
it's fucking insane, these people.
All right, let's go through the rest quickie.
Rest of them, yeah. So I'm going to blast through the ones that were no. Well, I'll just say no for the ones, but then I do have some notes for the ones that I kind of go, maybe. But again, these aren't hard-hitting mega yeses that fell. So it was require excessive admiration. I said possibly in the scope of these current events, he's pushed in a corner. So any kind of animal that is pushed into a corner out of its common environment will exhibit very not average behavior.
Will tattle on their friends, yes. That's what animals always do. Yeah. They go right to the police.
That is weird, the insertion of himself with that, but there's something there. I have some notes on that as well. Okay. So sense of entitlement and evident in these individuals, unreasonable expectation of especially favorable treatment. I don't think he's looking for favorable treatment. I think he is defending himself to try to look like the good guy because he is in this divorce situation.
Sure.
And there's drugs involved and this law stuff. So there is some stuff that will force him into this, like, I'm a good guy. You got to see this. See, so he is in this like defensive mode. So we can't, he's put on a defensive mode. So we'll give him that there.
Yep.
And that's what I'm saying. I'm trying to keep this within that scope. And also, you know, we can look into outside, you know, months prior to all this as well, which, you know, we could revisit. So then I have sense of entitlement combined with a lack of sensitivity to the wants and needs of others may result in the conscious or unwilling exploitation of others. So that one I kind of felt
ding,
with
ding, ding.
How he treats.
Yeah.
Yeah. That one was probably the one that stood out the most.
Yeah.
With this, I said, you know, but then you also have to consider that Nick is a kind of person of interest here, a conflicting person of interest with this. He was fucking his now to be ex-wife.
Probably still
How do you
is.
Not
that
have
was,
like
but yeah.
Yeah. What?
I think he still is.
Aaron, right. Aaron so it's really, like you're gonna.
She's still living with him.
You're gonna have a little animosity for this guy. You're
but I think Nick
paint him in a shitty light. He's doing you wrong. So you got to give him a little bit of that. So
what were you gonna say, Vinny?
I was going to say, I feel like Nick feels bad about it. That's why they're all going to church all the time.
Just repent. Keep doing it. Keep repenting. and then so I think like with, you know, there is this real significance, personal interest there. Mm-hmm. So there's that. And then here's number seven, generally have a lack of empathy and have difficulty recognizing the desires, subject, experience, and feelings of others. I don't think so. I have seen other clips of him. He does seem to be very insightful into others.
Well, all right. Could be right about this, Missy. I don't know a ton about Aaron and the whole thing, but the performative empathy part that we saw, and have the clips on here where he's watching Nick.
That is
kind of
weird, but I think that is a protective defense mechanism on his part with some things.
Okay.
With this in particular, again, we are scoping this in a very, very stressful situation. This isn't just like...
Well, before the stressful situation, though...
He lost a bet to
He was bringing his children to a drug den, though, on the weekends before this stressful situation.
Right. That totally supports the substance abuse disorder. There is a substance abuse disorder in personalities.
But he says he didn't even like drugs. I want to thank my friends at Magic Mind. I brought them up a few times. I brought Magic Mind with me to Las Vegas, and thank God I did. I couldn't have done those shows without it. It's a long day on Saturday doing the Creep Off and Who Are These Podcasts. Lucy, you were there.
I was.
You know the deal.
I do, and I couldn't do it without Magic Mind. I just had one right before this episode.
Did you? Yeah. Magic Mind is a very unique product. It's not like a caffeine shot or anything like that. It's a blend of different ingredients you can't find anywhere else. And what it does is it gives you focus, but it also eases your anxiety. And there's been a lot of talk about microdosing with mushrooms and stuff like that. I've talked to Dr. Steve about this. There's real science behind this. And I hope that the pharmaceutical community catches up at a certain point, because with people who suffer from depression, anxiety, and things like that, there are ingredients in mushrooms that, when taken regularly over time, will ease that and will change your life. And so, I start every day. I've been doing it for over a year now with Magic Mind, and it helps me out a ton. I do recommend it. The focus as well, but just easing anxiety. Hmm. Promo code WATPSHOW20 is what you want to use for 20% off. And visit magicmind.co/WATPSHOW20. And then you too could be going to Las Vegas with your Magic Mind. Yeah. And then giving the bill to Patrick Melton.
I wanted to go, but I was too scared and nervous.
Right, that's the thing. That's why Andy wasn't there. He didn't take his Magic Mind that day, and his knees were shaking. He decided not to go. Promo code WATPSHOW20. Visit magicmind.co/WATPSHOW20 to get 20% off.
It's like, okay. Listen, I want to be as I'm laying this out because I don't want to force a square peg into a round hole here.
I understand that.
So I'm not trying to deflate you. Like, listen, there's,
I'm just giving my point of view on this.
This is some pretty drama juicy shit going on.
It is.
But is this guy a full-on narcissist? I don't know yet. I'm not convinced. I wasn't convinced off the bat. I was trying to see some things, and so here's the remaining two: envious of others or believe others are envious of them. Not really getting that with him all the time.
Hold on. Maybe not all the time.
That's a big yes.
That's a big yes.
It is a big yes.
Because
okay.
He said recently, he goes, yeah, my numbers are up and Patrick Melton hates that. He hates that I have more people watching it than him and that I'm making more money. I've hung out with Patrick Melton all last weekend. He doesn't give a fuck. Patrick's living his best life. He's very content with what he's doing.
All right. We'll add that. We'll put that as a yes then.
But anyway, at least the part where he thinks other people are envious of him. For sure.
Right. And that's a guy who is protective of his show, and he is, you know, like, this is his show. Like, he wants to, you know, any angles and all that.
It's clear that Carl can't be neutral in this. No, of course not. Why would I be neutral?
I understand why you also have a biased personal involvement in this as well.
I just know what he's been saying lately, so I'm just filling in the blanks.
Yes. It turns out the B stands for blowing up the narrative. Way to go, Missy.
It's fine. It's
my job is to be, hey, is this a narcissist or not? And you know what? We're not going to be batting 1,000 every time.
And I will say, you're allowed to disagree with me on this show if you want. It's fine. Right? For
since when? Holy shit,
stick
Chris,
your head off, walk out. Oh my God. And then so number nine, and then this one I do have as a possibly is the arrogant, haughty behaviors characterize these individuals. They often display snobbish, disdainful, and patronizing attitudes, which I have been getting. That one stood out the most.
Yeah. Okay.
And again, like, does that make him a full-blown when I look at this, he doesn't meet that threshold personally. Does he have personality disorder? Absolutely. Is it a narcissist? I'm not convinced.
Well, Dr. C has been really focusing on borderline personality disorder, and he's been studying right. that quite a bit. And he sees a lot of those traits in some of the people that we talk about. I won't say yes. which ones, because Dr. Steve doesn't like to be outed. Even though I out him all the time because I'm an asshole. Because I can't help myself.
But, that is absolutely correct. And yeah. I think Dr. Steve would agree on this. And I think we got a person with a borderline personality disorder. No, maybe not borderline. Let's not go there. I'm not going to say that. But, you know, this guy's got some shit going on for sure. But not a narcissist in my book. I don't have my score sheet right now, but where would I put him? I would definitely put him lower than Tony Soprano.
I think he was about like a 4 or 5 out of these, right? 4 or 5? We gave him a yes on?
No, I would just give him a good 3.
Wow.
Maybe 4. All right,
Missy, I got to send you more clips then. We gotta do some more research on this.
I was really struggling here a little with this guy.
All right, so this is, there's a few clips here that I wanted to play. And Missy, if there's anything you want me to play specifically, let me know.
No, play away.
All right, so this is him addressing me. This is going to lead up to something that I want to show you that just happened this week. But this is going back a little ways. And Aaron addressing me specifically.
Adonis Inferno says, Aaron, we need to set a new goal for a nice vacation for you somewhere without a hot tub. These fucking assholes. These fucking assholes. Oh, man.
Thanks to Stalin 19 Doctor. For...
Hey, Carl, is it a fucking work, you... Hey, Carl, who's at work going, buddy? Fix my fucking hard drive, you IT...
Can I actually comment on the whole work thing? Yeah. So when I went back and I saw, like, what you said...
Yeah.
And now... And then how he reacted to it. I think it's a pretty fair, like, when you're like, this is so outrageous. He can't possibly... This can't be real... Because this must be a work. And if it's not a work, you said this, if it's not a work, then he's coming off as the biggest asshole or biggest piece of shit, you said.
Correct, yes.
So therefore, if you were to then say, like, go, oh, is a work? Do you not see the flip side of that, Aaron? That maybe you are being an asshole a little bit?
This is the problem.
And how you're handling it isn't making you look as great as you are trying to prop yourself up as. And now you're seeing that. And so you're tearing everyone else around you down so that you do look like a better person.
Go ahead, Betty.
That is a narcissistic like.
It is, yes.
You know, behavior. So if you're not those things and you really believe that, maybe take a step back and see what you're exhibiting and what people are seeing. So for you to get mad at Carl, I guess now it sounds like I'm like talking directly to him, but it's you to then like go, aha, Carl, see, it wasn't a work. Justifies you being a dick. So, you know, he kind of, you know, he stepped in his own shit with that, this comment.
Well, it's stupider than all of this. Yes. It is this is the stupidest thing this fucking guy could be mad at. There,
yes. It is.
I was giving the benefit of the doubt. I was nothing, bro, everyone says you're a piece of shit and your wife left you. And I'm saying there's no way that's true, Aaron.
Dude, there's no way you messed up your life this bad. I thought you were a smart guy. Yeah. There's no way you just, hey, Carl, you stupid idiot. Look at me fucking up my life.
But also, he doesn't know the flip side. But hold on, Missy, real quick. Yeah. He doesn't understand the flip side of it because he only reads the headlines. He just reads the thumbnail. And so he looks at these things or he hears information from people and he doesn't look into it anymore. And I'll prove that in just a moment because he keeps stepping in shit when he goes. And then Carl is an IT professional and he doesn't know shit. It's like none of this stuff is true. What are you talking about?
He is hypocritical in that way. You know, he says, like, I was watching really early clips, too, to kind of just get a general vibe of him.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, he is, you know, disingenuous in the sense where he goes, oh, you know, the Dabbleverse is so gay. It's so stupid. Like, why would you even do that? All of his stuff is clips of things that you too, Carl, have covered. So maybe there's just this jealousy animosity thing that he has, maybe. But
he joined the Dabbleverse. He started going after Chad Zubak. And
literally his shit is identical to yours.
Right.
In the not. Let me be clear when I say that. It's when I went through all of his video clips, it was MLC, Chad Zumok, you know, Steel Toe comments on Gino getting punched by Pac Dixon, you know, like literally all things. Like, so he's in it, so he's not above it. So
correct.
I think that he needs to accept that.
Just as an aside,
if I'm sorry,
no,
we went years getting comments in the Reddit how you wouldn't go after him.
Correct.
So it wasn't like you were trying to drag him in.
No, yeah. definitely not.
I just wanted to underscore that.
If I'm Aaron in this situation, my response to you is so simple. Thanks for giving me the benefit of the doubt, dude. Yeah. No, man, I wish it was a war, dude. I really wish it was, but things are this fucked up. I write a note, and then I hang myself in the garage. what I do if I'm Aaron.
That's why I texted him, because I was giving him a chance to give him an out. When he went on his show after this, and he goes, yeah, Chad Zumas got this all figured out. He's making a lot of good points. I wrote, oh, dude, you think Chad Zumas making good points? Now I know this is a work. Thinking he'd like have a little belly laugh with me and be like, instead he's just like, and fucking Carl texts me and says, but I'm like, oh my God, Aaron, you're not understanding this at all. But let me get back to this clip because I didn't even see this before today.
One thing real quick before that, I think there's more details, stinging details that we're unaware of that he is. So there is this dramatic irony that we are being part of where we're seeing him act this stuff out that we have no idea about. So it comes off as one way, and maybe there is more. I think that's why he kind of got so up in arms when you say that, because I think it's more serious than maybe he gives off, but he still feels the need to talk about it. And again, he's hypocritical because he has really, really embellished into this.
It's very serious.
Drama.
No, I understand that. This guy's entire life just blew up. I get that.
Yeah, yeah. No, so he's on like total like batting, you know,
but I don't know
behavior.
Where this, I don't know, I've never heard this before. This is news to me that he's saying that I'm an IT professional for some reason.
And gay.
That is, yeah, when I heard that, I
knew the gay thing. That I've heard. I was just at Hackamania. I've heard
that. We all know you love cock. This is your favorite month of the year.
Yeah, but yeah, I don't know if it's because I wear glass. I mean, he wears glass. I don't know. I don't know.
He's just trying to latch on something.
Speaking Mandarin to my friend. He's well-traveled.
Wow, well, I think this whole thing might be a work.
Mm. Wow, quite the fucking work.
What a work.
What a fun thing to put on as a work.
I don't need a bunch of people fucking telling me what a piece of shit I am, and then I feel bad when I fucking vent. Fuck that.
You already know what a piece of shit you are, goddammit.
But that's my thing. If I'm going to be a piece of shit, if no matter what I do, no matter how much fucking PR I run, no matter how much fucking protection I run.
Uh-huh.
I'm a monster, I'm a piece of shit, I'm garbage. Well, then let's be garbage.
That's a weird defense mechanism right
there. It's not.
You can't tell me that I'm an asshole, I already know it. It's like, no, I can too, though.
Sounds like some people we know locally.
Yep.
Again, he does not understand. You were taking his side and saying there's no way this was that bad. And you were saying, I don't think that this guy could have possibly fucked up that much. You were not judging him.
I called it the Melton show and told him he was wrong. And now I'm like ball washing Melton, everyone saying. It's like, you're getting this completely wrong. This is not what I did at all, but okay, whatever.
This is pitiful, actually.
Christ. Actually, let me get to the end of this because there's something that happens at the end that I wanted to play.
I don't know what to tell you. Then you're beyond saving.
Save your soul.
They're saying Carl's numbers are up. Well, then I'm honored. You know?
Okay, so at a certain point, he goes, Carl's just doing this because his numbers are down, and he's got Hackamania coming up, and they're not selling tickets. And then someone in the chat goes, actually, Carl's numbers are up. He goes, oh. So the thing that I'm picking up on, I have a few examples of this, is that Aaron just reacts. Something happens, and he just reacts, and he lashes out, and he's completely wrong about it. And then someone tells him he's wrong about it, and then he doesn't go, oh, well, I sound fucking stupid.
Disappointed!
Instead, he goes right to, oh, well, then he's an asshole for this reason, because... God bless Keanu. Missy, you're friends with Keanu.
I am.
Keanu and Gino, hung out with them a few times. They're great people. And she was on the show with Aaron on Thursday, just this past Thursday. And Aaron's going off about how Carl never admitted that he was wrong about that this was a work. Still.
What does that matter?
I don't know.
Why is it even a conversation?
Because he's trying to turn it to me.
It's the most insignificant thing in the world.
It's so stupid. But he's trying to turn it to me that I can't admit when I'm wrong for some reason. So, all right. So watch how this plays out. This is great. Thank you, Keanu.
Suck my dick.
Yes.
Right?
JS says.
Fuck off.
He says.
Disengage. Yeah.
Carl hammered you and called you an embarrassment. Dude, Carl's such a fucking embarrassment. A guy, like, he used to text and call Gino and I and talk about football and shit. And now he's going to pretend like, oh, yeah. And then he goes, the divorce was a work. And he still won't admit, oh, yeah, I fucked that one up. Aaron was right. He kind of made me look like a dick on that one. He won't
he
do
actually
it. Carl has bought into pro wrestling 100%. He can't be saved.
Well, start listening, Aaron.
He actually did admit. He was like, oh, yes, I was wrong about that.
Okay, good.
You've been busy, so you haven't seen it. But he did admit it. He went,
What a victory.
Tukey.
Right, yeah.
Tukey,
yeah.
Hit the drop. Hit the drop, Tukey. Another win for the toe.
Thanks. Another win for the toe.
So now he turns it around.
Right, I know. It's not a win.
So he goes, Aaron,
shot.
Keanu goes, Aaron, this thing that you've been yelling about for the last 2 weeks, you've been wrong about the entire time. And Carlos put out multiple videos proving that, and you just are not paying attention to it. And he goes, oh, well, then I win again because he admitted he was wrong. Like, what the fuck? But he can't help himself.
He doesn't realize what, see, that right there says that he doesn't really know what you said. Because
right.
Then again, it's going right. back to what you were saying, that it's admitting that he is a piece of shit. So, like, it kind of is a double-edged sword for him right here.
Yeah.
This motherfucker's calling you a dork. He has the fucking haircut of every nerd I've ever seen in my life.
He looks like he just got pulled out of the toilet.
I mean, he's got a buttoned-up polo shirt on. You're buttoning up your polo shirt, and you're calling other people a dork. Oh, my God.
Real quick, I'm going to – quick aside here. This. Because we were talking about on Point Dabble Point yesterday, Quad Father is, you know, centering John's
bro.
Sidekick now. And Pest says, Missy, can you confirm something? Was Quad Father ball washing some Proud Boys in Gavin's chat?
Bro, ball washing is an understatement.
Whoa!
I go in there because I was vetted into the Gavin server on Discord. And it's a crazy, wild little Discord, but I saw that Ryan was going into the audio chat, and I wanted to listen in because I was like getting ready to go out somewhere, and so I was listening, and I had myself on mute, and I'm just seeing whatever they're talking about, and I see, is it like Quad Father? I see is one of the names. I was like, no, that can't be like the same.
Yeah, there's probably lots of Quad Fathers, right?
And then like it's his like icon is like some dude in a wheelchair on fire, some like Red Dragon reference, I guess, and then he's talking, and he just sounds like a woman the entire time. Hey, and like one of those like annoying kind of fans that I've seen kind of like that are around whenever we go to events. They're like, hey, so like when you met like that guy, can you like tell me what he's about? Like, what is it like with this guy? It's like, it's so cringy.
Have you
and gay.
Smelled Trump? What does he smell like?
Yeah. Like shit like that. So he was doing that in the chat, and, then he asks, he's like, and Ryan, is like the whole thing between like you and Gavin and him yelling at you, he's like, is that real or not? Or and then like, so I chime in and I go, if you have to ask that question, then you don't know Gavin. Like, yeah. I thought this whole server was that you know who Gavin is and like you're a big fan and all that stuff. So I didn't embellish like I just did there. Like I didn't go any further, but right. I just said like, hey, like if you have to ask that, you know, you don't know Gavin. Then I muted myself. They're like, he's like, oh, a woman. In here, go make a sandwich and like being like all like douchey like that. And it was just
good
like,
one.
Okay, whatever, bro, yeah. Go ahead. And so, I just continue to listen. And then he doesn't have his camera up. So you can choose to have your camera on or not in this Discord thing. So then I notice some people put their video on. He then purposely rolls himself outside to have his like a bumper sticker of like, John 3:16 or something, you know, a Bible verse.
Yeah.
And just to kind of be like, hey, because you know, the big Christians in that kind of community.
Yeah.
And so he's trying to just show off. He's like positioning it. So you see it. And I was like, what the fuck is this guy doing?
Douche.
And it didn't stop there. And then he kind of just like would just ball wash. He was just like, yeah, man. Like, and it was just so cringy. And I started feeling bad for him, but then I didn't because he was like trying to shit on me just being girl. It's like, whatever, man. And then he takes his phone to show his Uhuru sticker, Proud Boys sticker, mm-hmm. and just like starts showing that. Like out of context, like pay attention to the room. Because I wanted to ask him why he's like sucks stuttering John's dick, but
right,
that's
yeah.
not kind of what the vibe was yet. There was no opening to kind of insert yourself. So I was like, all right, I guess I'll ask another time. But
you wanted to prove he belonged, Missy.
It was so gay. Like, just fucking be yourself. Like, I don't think he has an identity. Like, I think he just, like, he's trying to force himself with his,
he's a clout
like, on
chaser.
John.
He's a clout chaser for sure.
Total
yeah, we're
clout
getting that
chaser.
Sense.
Total fucking LARP.
I feel
like,
really bad
dude.
If John got upset because he heard he was in Gavin's chat.
Yeah, I feel
really bad about
from
that.
From Penis Wrinkle, yesterday Penis Wrinkle said that people have said that to John. He's like, oh, well, we don't talk politics.
Yeah, I know. John,
it's like,
John is
really,
like,
does that matter to you?
Cop out for that. I know, it's so weird. He tells me I'm great. every day, so it's okay.
At some point, one of them is going to
doesn't talk politics on his own political
show. Yeah, I know. That's other people talk politics.
Yeah. No, I'm wondering. I think I'm not a fan of Quadfather I already wasn't. And then when that happened, I was like, okay, fuck this guy.
Yeah.
And he, I think he's going to upset John soon, and John's then going to betray him, or one or the other. It's going to be soon.
That's what always
happens.
That's what always happens.
Yeah.
All right, let's get back to this, because there's more to this clip. And again, thank you, Keanu.
The children.
Carl.
But what about the children?
Fucking Tukey. Oh. I hope his spleen rotted off in the hospital. No, I hope
I don't know what's going on with that guy.
I hope Tukey is fine. I hope I hope Rocco's okay. I hope he's healthy. He does
He seems to be. Right?
He does some very funny things that people like. I'm sorry I'm a bit busy to check it out, but people like Rocco.
You'd laugh if you saw it.
I'm sure I would.
Hysterical.
I hope Rocco's doing great. I hope he's healthy, and I hope he can keep doing his characters and his YouTube stuff, because people seem to really enjoy it. I hear a lot about it.
You know what else I love about him? He enjoys it.
Yeah.
He really enjoys it. Gino was like, but the Dabblebirds, it's such yeah, the hate. And he's like, it's fun, do you know?
Yeah.
This is fun.
I hope Rocco's okay and that Carl gets cancer. No, I'm just kidding.
Whoa.
I don't. I think what Carl did to me was a little like sad or whatever, but he's allowed to do it. That's his thing.
Yeah, but he actually, I think you've been too busy to see, but he did admit it. He was like, well, here is a clip of me being like, I was wrong. Oh.
Well, then you know what? Here's what I'll say to Carl. Yeah. I'm sorry for beating the shit out of you over that, thinking you hadn't said that you were wrong. Thank you for admitting you were wrong. It takes a big man to admit you were wrong. And I really did lose my marriage. Ha ha, I got you.
Ha ha, Carl, it's so funny. Divorce. Yeah. It's so cool.
Fuck you, Carl. I won. I'm divorced for the second time with three kids. I got resale value out the ass. Suck my dick, Carl. I won.
Another win
for the toe.
He didn't know what to do with himself.
Yeah. He doesn't know where he's going with it.
Because he had his narrative. He's like, I'm mad at Carl because Carl won't admit that he's wrong, and he was wrong. And so that's why I'm mad at Carl. He's just like, well, no, you can't be mad at him because he actually did admit it. And he's like, fuck.
Now I got to stay on brand.
Yeah,
so
now I'm mad at Carl.
What do I do?
I've never, like I said, I'm just started watching this guy over the last week or two.
Yeah.
Who the fuck watches this show with this guy? Who cares about that?
Well,
I mean, he doesn't even understand your point that he's railing on about.
Correct. So this is hilarious because it's another perfect example of what we just saw. Now, Nick Rekieta finally did his first stream to talk about this. And of course, Nick is going to have some issues with Aaron because Aaron is the reason why Nick's front door got knocked down by the police. It's in the search warrant that the detective was watching Aaron's show and decided, based on what Aaron was saying about his drug use with the Rekietas, that they need to go in there and rescue these children from these drug addicts. It's in the search warrant. It's Aaron's fault that this happened to him. So finally,
another win for the toe.
So finally, Nick does a live stream, and everyone's like, oh, you got to see what Nick said about you on this live stream. And what's great is that Aaron did not curate this, did not do any prep, just went, I'll just watch it on my show, and let's see what happens.
But
look at that.
Don't. I mean, some of it I can't.
By the way, right now what he's doing, he's threatening text messages and images that he has on his phone that he can leak to the internet that would embarrass Nick Rekieta. That's what he's doing. He's pointing to his phone. He's like, you better not do anything. You better not say anything to me because I'll leak all of this stuff.
Well, I mean, this man, Aaron, is clearly past embarrassment.
Like, yes.
He's incapable of being embarrassed, if you think.
It's crazy.
Some of it to release pub. I mean, the degeneracy we all engaged in, I can't show a soul.
Okay, can you pause real quick?
Yeah, of course.
So he's threatening. He has all this, like, deep information and whatnot, right?
Yeah.
Now, and we don't know the status of Nick's case. And if it goes to discovery, I'm getting the impression that Aaron is implicating himself and will have to hand over said text messages that he's threatening to harm Nick, which I think would harm Aaron. So this is, again, speculation on my part because I don't know what's going on, but he's not doing a good job at removing himself from a potential lawsuit.
correct. Yes.
Okay.
Cool. I would agree.
Right.
With
I thought
you
I was
that.
Just a stupid woman for a second. Sorry.
Well, it's, it, but it's not even the lawsuit is as far down the road. I mean, Nick right now has a legal case against him that he has to worry right. about first. He's got to keep himself out of jail.
Well, if discovery comes, you get discovery before really, you know, like you're sitting in the court, you know, that's yeah. all behind the scenes.
Oh, they collect
so
the evidence,
they could
right.
contact him and be like,
they will.
Hi, you.
They will definitely, this detective will contact Aaron. If this goes to trial, now they might settle and none of this, and this all goes away.
Sure.
Who's going to settle? The state?
Right, I was going to say, like, isn't this against the state?
The state is
going to
settle shit.
They settle all the time.
It's a criminal charge.
No, they settle all, dude, they settle everything out. No one goes to court anymore. It's not even a thing. I actually got jury duty.
Stutter John has a lot of fucking lawsuits coming down the pike.
I had jury duty not that long ago, and it was a guy who killed a RPD, and I was like, holy shit, this is actually going to go to trial? So we're all sitting in the fucking courtroom for a couple hours, and the lawyers are in the back, and then they come out and they go, all right, he decided to plea his a deal. It's like okay. They always do.
Well, you mean plea out.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Settlement, it sounds like you're talking about
civil.
I'm
sorry, you're right. You're right. That's a good point. I meant plea, yes. Okay. Because they never go to court. But if it does go to court, yes, they're definitely going to subpoena Aaron and get all this shit that he's talking about he has on his phone.
100%.
Yeah.
Missy is 100% right. I didn't even think about this. Waving that phone around, I have evidence. Yeah. Not smart.
You are completely yeah. right. He's not a smart guy.
Don't do that.
The text
don't
I can show, dude, this is, I got to be honest, it's desperate. The only thing I can think is that maybe he did it to get me to over-respond.
So now he's making this all about him.
Mm-hmm.
So he's going, yeah, Nick is playing 4D chess, and he's trying to get me to do this thing. It's not all about you, Aaron.
Why does this remind me of that episode of South Park where Cartman takes a picture of Butter's balls in his mouth? He's going to fuck it like everybody else.
Yeah. It's exactly like that. Yeah. Actually, now I think about
it's pretty good.
It's the same thing. All right, so let's fast forward a little bit in this video.
Nick Naylor says, you might have already answered this or refused to, but any comment on what Aaron said?
Okay, so this is Nick Rekieta, first live stream, reading the chat. Any comments on what Aaron said? This is what we're all waiting for. What is Nick's response to Aaron accusing him of all this wife swapping and drug use and everything else?
Not the legal parts. Like I said, all of this stuff will probably be addressed in time, but
oh yeah, it will be.
Best I can say, and the simplest I can say, is that the truth.
Oh, let's do a little body language here. Are we looking up and away?
I know.
Isn't that usually a good body language indicator that you're about
actually,
to tell
it's
a
wrong? Blah. Can you pause that?
Yeah.
Pause on pause. Looking up and away is not a lying trope. It's like a gain, looking for information. Like I'm like, oh, what is that again? Yeah, when you look up in a way, when you look down is a lie.
Oh, okay.
When you look down in a way, that is
so
the
up in a way is like collecting your thoughts. How do I want to say
yes,
this?
It's
how should I communicate
like,
this?
Yeah, I'm like, what was that again? It was not. Yeah, okay. You look up when you do that. It's not a lie.
But Vinny, you made the gesture right there. The fact that this guy's talking about anyone's body language is insane. He's constant.
That's a reflection of on Aaron's
yeah. When
part.
He does that hugging thing, he's very uncomfortable and he's looking for any way to kind of fish out, and so he's gonna kind of over embellish and very obvious.
Maybe that's why he stares at the corner demon so much. People who have substance problems, which Nick may very well have, I mean, I would say he does, in my opinion, they tell a lot of lies. Don't I know it? So maybe that's why we're looking to the corner all the time. All right, I'm excited. Sorry, guys, I'm excited.
Simplest I can say is that the true story lies somewhere divergent from pretty much any orated story.
That's it.
As for Aaron, he'll say what he says. People can assess him for who he is without my input.
That's it.
I hope he makes $1 million.
Oh,
wow. Well said, Nick. You gave him zero. You gave him zero ammo, zero fuel right there.
All while attacking his credibility.
And correct. Yeah. Like, he knows that Aaron is being mocked across the internet. So yeah. He's just like, I mean, we're going to listen to this fucking asshole that everyone thinks is a piece of shit?
What an artist that he was taking shots from the high road.
Yeah. Yes. It's not easy to do, but very impressive.
Over the grassy
right
knoll.
Very impressive. So now how's Aaron going to handle this? Because he was all ready to fire back at something.
Yeah. Oh, man. All right, so he couldn't bring himself to say I'm lying. You know what? I'm sorry. People had me all juiced up thinking that he said I'm a liar. So he couldn't even bring himself. That's good. That was a little more honest than what I'm used to out of him.
I'm glad
I didn't go a lot harder.
See, there is a little self-awareness with that guy. See, this is where he's not a narcissist.
Well, but like he's trying to spin it in his head how he's gonna deal with this now. Because he had a plan going into this.
I'm sure. But his reaction is not a narcissistic reaction. They are very reactive people. And yes. Because they immediately hit their ego with every little thing. He actually has this shit, okay. Like, he actually has the patience.
Yeah,
and,
good point.
You know, so this is where I he's not. He's not. So, you know.
He did call him a liar. He said it. He said the truth is different than any orated story that you've heard. Translation, he's telling lies when he speaks.
Yes.
So either this guy's too stupid to know what that means, or he's just in his own way trying to spit it however he wants to get the story out.
He did word it in a way that says that all the information that's out there about me is incorrect. You know, he didn't say Aaron specifically. Now, does it mean Aaron? Of course it does. Aaron's the one who's saying the most shit about all of us. He's the one who's giving us all the information. But the way that Nick said that, and you're right. I mean, if his whole goal was to go out here and be like, oh, I'm lying. I have the fucking evidence and I was there and I know this is all true. Like, he could have reacted that way after what Nick said. Right?
Of course he could.
Could have, but
okay.
I was really ready to go on that one. That's not so bad. You guys on the internet, you get people so worked up. Dude, before the show, I'm sitting here screen grabbing text. I'm ready to throw them all out there. Here you go. So he didn't say, he's not as dumb as he looks.
No, but you are.
Yeah.
Why the fuck wouldn't you know what he was going to say if you're all ready for this big reveal of these reactions? I mean, just read some comments on the internet and goes, oh, sweet. Can't wait to watch this live and react to it. All right, so I just have one more clip from later on in this as Aaron continues to reel.
Somebody just telling you my story, telling you what I saw. So that wasn't so bad. You guys made it sound like he called me a liar. He didn't really call me a liar. He said the truth. He goes, all this stuff will come out and that your version is divergent from the truth. That's a douche way of calling you a liar. No, what I took for that is that he said any orated story. He said, basically, he's saying everything everyone's been saying, the truth lies divergent from that. Ooh. So
the biggest orator.
You're right. For everyone's getting their
facts.
That's
not bad enough to drop these soul crushing receipts. And I'll tell you why.
Whoa.
I'll tell you the actual reason why I don't just want to flood the internet with these. One, it looks cheap. Two,
like
authorities may need them eventually, and I'm not going to put them out there publicly and, you know, call that up.
Well, you were about to based on what Nick was going to say. That's kind of odd. He's like, all right, I'm going to be the bigger person.
I'm going to put the pin back in the hand grenade.
Yeah. Soul-crushing receipts. Wow. Who are these